ऊपर बैठे दैट इज बेटर अब ये करेक्ट ये
हेलो फ्रेंड्स वी हैव गॉट प्रभाकर कोल्टेजी विद अस अ वेरी वेरी फेमस आर्टिस्ट फ्रॉम बॉम्बे एंड ही हैज एग्जीबिटेड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड एंड no need of my explanation is already well known artist most well known artist from the country log kehte hain prabhakar kolte bahut sare bolte let's see let's start with it let's see kitna bol lete hain sir this is a discussion in chat okay sir aapse main pehla baar bhi jab baat kar rahe the to you said that master craftsmanship is all about putting a full stop in art would you stand with these words
still yes of course I am very strong now kyunki craft एक अलग बात है और आर्ट इज अलग यू अंडरस्टैंड क्योंकि आर्ट में क्राफ्ट होता ही है लेकिन क्राफ्ट ओवर पावरिंग नहीं होता है क्राफ्ट के जरिए एक वो जरिया है आर्ट की तरफ जाने का लेकिन उसको आर्ट नहीं बना सकते क्राफ्ट को आर्ट नहीं वो एक टेक्निक है एक माध्यम है जिससे हम आर्ट का जो एसेंस है वो निकाल सकते हैं लेकिन होता क्या है कि ज्यादातर आर्टिस्ट क्राफ्ट तक ही सीमित रहते
हैं लोग ज्यादा काम कर लेते हैं कैनवास में जो आगे काम हो चुका है उसके ऊपर ओवरवर्क करके काम खराब करते हैं तो वहां पे आपको क्या लगता है कि
वो इसके लिए होता है मैं समझ गया इसलिए होता है कि आई थिंक इट्स ए साइन ऑफ कंफ्यूजन खराब इसलिए कहते कि उन्हें कोई आइडिया नहीं है कि हम क्या कर रहे हैं और कहां तक करना है समझे ना वो करते जाते हैं यू अंडरस्टैंड टिल दे थिंक दैट दे आर सैटिस्फाइड टेक्निकली यू नो दे शुड बी सैटिस्फाइड दैट एसेंस वाइज एसेंस ऑफ आर्ट एसेंस ऑफ दैट सब्जेक्ट और व्हाट एवर इट इज ऑफ दे आर पेंटिंग यू नो
राइट
उसको नहीं वो देखते वो समझते कि क्राफ्ट को जितना अच्छा करेंगे तो आर्ट अच्छा हो जाएगा तो क्राफ्ट एक जैसे कि सेकेंडरी है और आर्ट द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ आर्ट इज प्राइमरी वो प्राइमरी भूल जाते हैं और सेकेंडरी को उठाते इसलिए वो काम करते जाते उनको लगता है ऐसा काम करना ही नहीं आता नहीं तुम काम 10% करो और 90% तो आप प्रोड्यूस कर सकते हैं ये बात है
सो आई बीन वाचिंग योर वर्क फॉर लाइक फॉर माय चाइल्डहुड बट बिग फैन ऑफ योर वर्क आल्सो सो हाउ डू आई प्लेस योर वर्क आर यू एब्स्ट्रक्शनिस्ट Are you, you are action painter or you are fauvist? I mean, how you place yourself?
I would say I'm a painter.
That's nice.
Just a painter. Why should I say fauvist or abstractionist? These are the terms to recognize a kind of art.
Exactly.
You understand?
Exactly.
But if I'm painting figurative or abstract or any kind of work, you know.
Right.
Because I paint, I bring something in. On the canvas, in reality,
right.
I'm a painter.
Right.
That painting is my media.
Right.
You know, my medium, and through that medium, I'm trying to express myself.
Yes.
So now, because all these terms are existing, realistic, abstract, semi-abstract, installation, etc. So people, or rather, the appreciator wants to fit me in somewhere. You know. So then, in that case,
like David Hockney always been saying that I'm not a pop artist.
Yes, but, exactly.
Art critics and everyone wanted to say that he was the father of pop art.
Pop art, yes.
And the best part of David Hockney, what I could appreciate is that in the last age, you could see the last exhibition, which I remember, he did a landscape exhibition.
Yes, yes.
And he's been experimenting all his life with various medium, which nobody other, no other artist in the world has ever dared to experiment with, actually. And that's the main reason why he was named that he's a father of pop art.
Right.
And he had a courage. That's a courageous move from the kind of work we know David Hockney is very well known. From that to change into a landscape all of a sudden at that last age of his life. It is very drastic change and such kind of boldness.
Yeah.
I don't see any Indian artists like Raza always in his lifetime he did in the same pattern, same theory, same thing. Don't you think there was a need for certain break?
I think the generation of Raja has not changed, you know. And you cannot bring change every now and then. But Souza, Raja, Hussein, Gaitunde,
Bakre. Yeah.
They have all of this all changed during that particular time. They are all responsible for it.
Yeah.
You see?
Progressive
and
progress.
That change is still lasting. You know? Now we need somebody to change it. And I'm sure that somebody in future will come and he will again change.
Absolutely.
That's one person cannot change, one person can inspire, you know. But change has to be brought by the fraternity of artists.
Right.
You understand? And to sensible artists.
Yeah.
Who feel that this is enough. Mm-hmm. Now we should come out, you know. And that is how the art went on changing.
But somewhere I feel like if you take up last 20 years of art history, so most of the artists on the globe were going in certain kind of a trend, but where painting was diminishing almost. But today we see artists like Lucien Freud is one of the very big name in the globe. So he didn't go with the flow, but still he's a very big name. Don't you think it's just not essential that you have to go with the flow? You can be your own and still you just do it. Then you enjoy.
Yes, see, that change is necessary sometimes, you know. Sometimes it is a fact that it has to come.
Right.
You know,
it's not a idea.
But it doesn't, it is not binding the artist, you know. One artist may say, no, I don't agree with this change. I will change when I want to change.
Absolutely. The artist should change when they want to change.
So there are artists like that. They don't, because see, right now the installation is going on.
Yes.
But many artists are following that. But some artists, they know, because I don't understand, I don't feel need to do installation. When I feel need, I will do it.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly.
So changes in particular life, individual life, and change in society, these are two different things. But the change in one person can affect the society.
That is very true.
You know, and that is how it has happened right from the beginning of history of art, you know.
Right.
So I feel that ultimately it is not just language, you know, it is an experience.
It is beyond the language.
Yes, beyond the language.
Beyond
it
the
is
language.
An experience. You cannot put that experience in words all the time, you know.
Yes. That's why Rabindranath Tagore started painting.
Yes, exactly.
Because when he started, like, he was suffocating with his vocabulary, he said that no more vocabulary is coming out of my brain. It's like I need colors to express
absolutely
myself.
Right. No, he was not a painter that way, you know.
No,
but then that way,
he wanted to express
his personality.
Yeah, he wanted to express himself.
He is a poet, he was a singer, he was a musician, he was a painter, he was a philosopher.
Yeah.
He was a saint, you know. So, all in one. And that is why he is Rabindranath.
Yeah.
There is no other Rabindranath.
But know? Two things, in certain level, I find that many of our Indian artists are they are carrying the signature is more important than their work. Sometimes signature becomes, stylization and signature making and branding himself is nowadays becoming more and more important.
But who is making that brand? Not artists.
No,
the society or the collectors or buyers, they make that brand, you know.
But still, the artist can be revolutionist and they can be a rebel and they can just turn that thing off and
there are artists like that. They don't respond to such things. But if somebody supports that kind of idea,
right,
nothing wrong. After all, he is also a human being. If he is not doing anything, but if somebody else is doing for him, nothing wrong. We are all
wrong. What I mean to say is that being an artist, you must always enjoy the freedom of expression.
But that he is enjoying. He is not labeling that I am a great artist or anything. The people are saying. People are buying his work. People are saying he is selling his work. You know. हेलो
क्या आप जाएंगे क्या फिल्म देखने
जा रहे हैं थोड़ा सा ये अभी चालू है।